Hello there, Alyshia from Scitech here, and welcome to Toy Teardown, the video series where we take toys you know and love and we pull them apart and try and use science to explain how they work. As always, we're here at Scitech on beautiful Wajak Noongar Budja, and today we're going to be having a look at the mystery of sticky hands.
I'd been asked to investigate a sticky situation. Someone had got their hands on something big. The investigation stretched out for years, but no theory would stick. The hands kept leading me somewhere. Nowhere. I had so many questions. This toy, what is it? What is it made of? Only questions, but no answers. Why can't I get any answers? I'd exhausted all possible options. There was only one thing left to do. Time for me to do a little investigation of my own. It was time to tear this toy down.
Ugh, kind of smell weird. I don't know about you, but I don't actually ever remember asking for a sticky hand, but I definitely had one as a kid. Maybe I think I might have got it from like an arcade or something with, I don't know, the 10 tickets I won at Time Zone. It's probably the cheapest toy I could have got. Every time I had one of these, it probably lasted about 5 minutes before it got completely covered in fluff or cat hair and then was unusable. But it turns out you can actually wash them to make them sticky again. I don't know, they're just a super satisfying toy, and I'm super excited to tear these down today. So I wanted to try and work out what material these are made of. And so I did a lot of Googling and did a little research, and I couldn't find anything. Turns out a lot of other people have the exact same question as me. So there was quite a few people on forums making some very educated guesses as to what they're made of. But no one was 100% sure, so it seems to be a bit of a well-kept secret, a little bit of a mystery. What we do know is that these are made of some kind of synthetic, rubbery, sticky polymer. And even though we don't know exactly what it's made of, we can still make some observations and do some experiments. Now, there's two really distinct things about this toy. One is that it's super stretchy. And the other is that it's incredibly sticky. Now, we're not going to talk too much about why it's super stretchy, because the composition of the material is quite complex chemistry, so I'm going to palm that off to someone else. But here's some of the words that I would have had to have pronounced if we did talk about that. We're actually going to talk today about why this thing is so sticky. Now, when it comes to stickiness, we call it adhesion. Adhesion. And adhesion is how one thing sticks to another thing, just like how this thing was sticking to the roof. The other thing is cohesion, which is how the thing sticks to itself. So if you imagine a water droplet and how it sits on a leaf, adhesion is it sticking to the leaf, and cohesion is the water droplet actually remaining together and sticking to itself. So now that we've had a bit of a chat about adhesion and cohesion, I want to put some of those things to the test. First question that I've got is it sticky the whole way through? Or is it just like a sticky outer layer? So I think the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna open it up and see. Sorry, mate, you've lost your thumb. All right. So it's not just sticky on the outside, it's definitely also sticky on the inside. I think we're gonna have to do a lot more experimentation on this to test out its adhesion and cohesion. And for that, I think we're gonna have to go outside. So we're here at the Scitech garage and we're gonna do some experiments today. So I chucked a sticky hand in the freezer overnight and I want to see if it's still sticky. So let's find out. All right. Ah. So the first thing I've noticed is that it's definitely still bendy. I definitely thought it would freeze solid, so that's kind of surprising to me. Let's see if it's still as sticky as it was before. So I'm gonna ditch it at our truck goose here and see if it stays. Ready? So our sticky hand did not freeze solid in the freezer, so it must have a much lower freezing point. We're gonna need something quite a bit colder, I think. So we're gonna test it out in some liquid nitrogen, which boils at minus 195 degrees Celsius. Okay, let's see if our sticky hand freezes when we put it into liquid nitrogen. Blah. Sticky hand. Are we ready? Oh no! It's done something! It's stuck to the inside! Ah! Nope. All right, what's gonna happen? Okay, so. Hey, ready? Whoa! That was super awesome. We managed to finally get a bit of a sticky hand explosion. It's gonna be a big mess to clean up. Anyway. Now we know what happens when we freeze sticky hands. What happens when we heat them up? Let's find out. Welcome to Alyshia's cooking show on Toy Teardown. Put on the hot plate and melt it down. I don't know if you've ever smelt burnt plastic before, but a very nice smell. Oh, that's heated up pretty quickly. Not a lot happening. Just wait. So it's starting to melt a little bit. I can see basically what looks like all of the food coloring coming off of it. This looks like disgusting spaghetti. Mmm, delicious. This is one of the stranger things I've ever done. One of them. So we're just reducing this, we're just waiting for this to come to a boil and then we'll reduce it down and wait for the gravy to thicken. Might just pour it out and see what happens. All right. Let's see how we're doing over here. Ah, my nonna would be so proud. Look at this thing that I've cooked. Ah, how's it gonna peel off? Oh, it's still a little bit melty, but I can confirm it is still very, very sticky, so we can see that, oh wow, that's crazy. That is so cool. So turns out melting it down and kind of pouring it back out again, it actually still remains very sticky. So it isn't a coating. It's really bizarre. Really, really bizarre to hold. All right. I'm gonna see if this can, whoa, that is awesome. Looks like a horrifying fruit roll-up. So fascinating. It kind of looks like a, Like a living organism or something. What have I created? We did a whole bunch of experiments today with sticky hands, which was super duper fun. Discovered that you can actually melt them down. They are sticky inside. They do stretch really quite far. I'm pretty sure this would stretch even further. They do freeze when they touch liquid nitrogen, not so much solid when you put them in the freezer. And I'm just so excited to maybe try some more experiments with sticky hands. So we're gonna hold on to all the sticky hands we have. Maybe we're gonna make something else out of that. But if you guys have any ideas about what we can do with sticky hands, let us know, and we might just try it out here at Scitech. Please let us know if you have any ideas on what we can do with this very strange and mysterious substance. Thank you so much for watching Toy Teardown. Until next time.